Good evening, everybody. It is a great moment of emotions full of happiness around. I took over as a president of IAG in June 2019. Before I begin my year or presentation, let me say thank you for giving me this opportunity. I take very seriously the trust placed in me by you all. And in Ahmedabad, I promised you all at the time of installation, 1.5 years ago, that I will work very hard with my entire team and try to fulfill these responsibilities. The time has come to present our work, what we did in a year. But before I start, let me thank few people. Good friends are like stars. You don't always see them, but you know they are always there to guide you. And these are my friends across the country who has helped me in making and shaping my year. I immensely thank our past presidents who has made this organization, the beautiful organization, and given in our hand. We saw this during this election. How much everyone wants to work. And this organization has become one of the most vibrant organizations of the country. My Pune friends and my team Ahmedabad, I thank you all from bottom of my heart. I know the amount of efforts each and every one of you have taken during our installation annual conference. I missed my friend Dr. Praveen Patel immensely in Ahmedabad. Today, what I am is my team, Ruby Hall Clinic, who has given me a platform to perform, and I'm performing over there for more than 2.5 decades. And my gynec department, a fantastic friends with me, and my dear friends and fellows all across. They make our life actually, or I can say they bring the meaning to our life. With the new team comes new strength and new thoughts. And we got our fantastic managing team. Reshma Pai as immediate past president, Bhaskar Pal, Krishna Kumar, Pandit, Atul Ganatra, and most importantly, it was, if you say about Bhaskar Pal, I would like to put up one photograph of him. These were his expressions. He never loves to come in the morning. Good morning, Bhaskar, when you say. He said, but main to so raha hu na. But with every phone call, he will be there to help me, to guide me, to give his valuable suggestions. It helped me to shape up immensely because of my dear friend. I was blessed to have a fantastic managing committee of the year. You can never dream of anything. We build a team with the same dream, and teamwork makes the dream work. All my these members, they have really taken efforts to understand my vision and just to implement on my vision. The best way to predict your year is to create it. And what was important with my team was, we are not a team because we work together. We are a team because we respect, trust, and care for each other. We know everyone is busy in their private practice. And how do we go about it? So it was very important to give a proper job, and everyone did it fabulously. Talent wins the games, but teamwork wins the championship. And this is what my team has shown. I just want to thank each and every one of you. You all behaved like it's your presidential year. And that's why we got successful. We started with our team. The theme of the year was E equal to MC square. This Lego of IAG, I love it. We designed it during Nandita's presidency when I was a secretary. Our theme E equal to MC square means endoscopy equal to mastering challenges twice. We all know that in endoscopy, we face many challenges and we need to master them again and again. So, with this theme, we started with and then we set out the goals of certain academic activities. Our whole team got installed in Endo ATM conference in Ahmedabad. This was one of the most memorable conference, and the beauty of it was getting a medal from none other than Dr. Reshma Pai. She's so tremendously experienced. She's the best leader I have seen. And it was wonderful to have her in a team to guide us for entire year. My Pune clad whole gang had come there. And I love you all. And the amount of efforts and time you took out, we released the activities what we were supposed to do for the entire year that time. And Dr. Sanjay Patel, Dr. Mahesh Gupta, and your entire team, we enjoyed felicitating you for your hard work. The most historical moment was IAG-AHL collaboration. We collaborated with AHL for 5 years. So all AHL, sitting president, incoming president, the office bearers, and Linda, they all came in India, and then we signed our agreements. I need to thank Dr. Shailesh Puntambekar for helping us and for getting this done. We all went to Vancouver. This was our collaboration. The Indians, we all will be there. And they will be with us in our annual conference. And I welcome today Dr. Jubilee Brown, who is virtually present. And I miss those who could not make it, but we will be hearing them tomorrow in our scientific program. Friends, we started with a bunch of academic activities in mind. Set a goal so big that if you achieved it, it would blow your mind. And that's what really happened. When I look back, when I was compiling this with the help of Bhaskar, Sejal, Abhishek, I realized we are not ending in collecting data. The amount of work which we have done is huge. And this is because of each and every endoscopist of the country. We thought of making the program, keeping in mind postgraduate student, young gynecologist, gynecologist who wish to advance their skill. Also, in India, there are many, many endoscopists. They are great, but unfortunately, they are in smaller places or their nature is not to come in limelight, and then they don't get a platform. We decided to give a platform to them with our star conferences. Why this Eagle project? This project has become one of the most memorable projects. Every aspiring gynecologist learns endoscopy. Friends, unfortunately in India, we still don't have endoscopes or the systems in government colleges. And our residents, we know they are intelligent, skillful, but they lack the vision or they lack the skill. So we decided to conduct 2 days program. I need to thank Johnson & Johnson immensely, and along with many companies who provided us all the machineries free of cost. Sometimes it used to happen, there is in a north, there is in a south, at the same time in various medical colleges, but they kept the whole team. Now, when this project, we wanted to do it, first important thing was getting all endoscopies together. Because it's a huge task. We have near 500 medical colleges. And then in these colleges, we wanted all medical colleges to be covered, but it is impossible in 1 year tenure. And then I appealed to all my future presidents and they agreed to take over this. I made all endoscopists of the country, near 200, it's impossible to put up the photos of all, but near 200 endoscopists joined their hands. And then we made zonal coordinators, state coordinators, city coordinators. We chopped out the medical colleges, talking to those head of the departments, taking out the time, collaborating with the companies, and then making the 2 days program over there was a huge task. And it would not have been possible without all the help of endoscopists. So my zonal coordinators, E-Zone, Dr. Sujata Kar and Dr. Arun Barua, they have done a huge job. Believe me, I was not even aware of the name of the cities. Forget just the medical colleges. We started with Bhuneshwar, the first Eagle project. We did in Brahmapur, Burla, Zorat. It's not possible to cover every medical college. Time will go whole day for that. But Arun and Sujata has done a huge job. In a waste zone, Sejal and Abhishek, they have one quality. They never say no. It's always okay. And Deven Jogal and Manish Pandya, they collected all these people and they worked with the HOD. We did it in Bhuj. We did it in Jamnagar, in Rajkot, in Gujarat. Then in Navi Mumbai, where I myself have gone, Maimar Medical College, Pune, Navi Mumbai Medical College, Aurangabad Medical College with help of Dr. Pandey and Wadia Medical College. This was a great job done by Dr. Rajesh. He has collected all India, near 300 students. You can see them sitting in the auditorium. And then we released from Wadia. So at a time, we could work out with 300 residents. That was a huge thing. Then the Surendra Nagar and Ahmedabad itself. Sujal, thank you so much. You all did a wonderful job. KM Hospital, Mumbai, they also wish to do it. Most importantly, you can see Abhishek enjoyed working with those young residents. I'm not saying flirting, I'm saying working. Latur Medical College, Kalyan and his team along with Rajesh and Brahmapur, all they worked. North Zone. I know how much Anupam and Kavita has to travel to the North Zone. My wonderful coordinators, they kept on coordinating. They got the faculty from the local area and they did amazing job in various medical colleges, including Ludhiana. The residents gave me call in the evening. They used to feel so thrilled holding the telescope and working on that. Believe me, there is no more happiness than getting their phone calls. South Zone, the vibrant zone, Subhash Malya and Kalyan, they did again a huge job. You can see Parul traveling all the way from Gujarat to Madurai along with Mala. In a Kerala, we had it. The enthusiasm of South was equally bursting. Calicut Medical College, Chennai Medical Colleges, and many more, Alapuzha. See, so many medical colleges you come to know. None of us know these 500 medical colleges. Vidya did a huge job with Subhash in Bangalore Medical College. All the girls, I need to really, really thank Johnson & Johnson. It's not so easy to carry so many pelvic trainers and go over there. We gave all the participants these digital certificates. Now we decided the zonal coordinators will be there for 3 years so that they know which colleges they have worked in and which colleges they have promised and unfortunately could not perform. It always seems impossible unless it's done. After 3 months of a huge coordinating networking work, we all did it amazingly. I thank each and everyone, the head of the department, the residents, the associate professor, everyone worked like a conference they have in their college. For the young gynecologist who have never performed, we wanted to have more smaller social group and have morning half showing them the surgeries, an afternoon half, motivating them, sitting with them, giving them a talk. We started doing it. We organized this one-day conference, and the same surgeries we discussed, mainly in the Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities, apart from metro cities as well. These were the programs which we organized, and even Dr. Kumar, everyone helped. Parul, you did amazing help to me in India, in traveling all across. We did it in Pune, and we collected all the peripheral near 100 kilometers, doctors there coming, and Manish and Ashish and Mahendra all came in Ruby Hall, and we did a beautiful job there, while in Chennai also we did it. I can't keep on showing you all the photographs, but believe me, those gynecologists, they have now established their practice, wants to move ahead, wants to know more. In the major conferences, there is always such a big group, and they may not have time to go and spend months together from their busy practice. It was real motivational conferences. Now, Bali, balancing advanced laparoscopy in India, again thanks to Johnson & Johnson, who gave their animal lab in Mumbai and Chennai. Now, what was this aim of this program was, those who are doing level 2 and level 3 and wants to go for more advanced surgeries, it was hands-on training on the anesthetized animal for them. So the group in Mumbai was all so enthusiasm. Ganpat, Abhishek, I must say, Ameya and Vivek Salunke, they did initiative. Vivek Salunke was in charge of the program, and we declared every month. Believe me, all 4 months were booked immediately, because per anesthetized animal, if you are giving only 4 member, you can't accommodate more. And that's what, but they all enjoyed this Bali project. It took us little 2-3 months, but this project now got established, and we had whole day activities. I used to meet these people virtually. You can see my photograph there. Even before the COVID effect, we were digitally advanced, and we were showing our digital presence whenever possible. This project was done even in Chennai. Mala, Ashok, Meenakshi, all Chennai team helped me, and they taught the endoscopist who wanted to enhance their skill. Basically, all endoscopists of India, they believe that a candle loses nothing by lighting another candle. And I love you for this thought. We always teach this, because during residency, we learn that. The seniors have taught, and the time has come to teach our juniors. Now, as I said, we wanted to give a platform to many gynecologists, and that's where the Star Endogyne Conclave was. What we did in Star Endogyne Conclave was, we organized 3 days workshop. These 3 days workshop consisted of, first day, live surgeries, 80% belonging to that state and 20% flew down from all across. Our theme was spaces, technology, advances and research. And next 2 days were the scientific program. So these star conferences of 3 days, I again thank each and every organizing chairperson. Every conference of these had my managing committee members as a coordinators. So two members were taking completely only that. So Vivek and Kalyan had only job to coordinate with my convener Lakshmi there in Nagpur and conduct the program. Same way, Nitin and Subha, Mahendra, they did it in Indore. Fantastic job. The Indore team, they made 6 workshops. They combined even ART fertility enhancing workshops over there. Then Delhi got associated with us, Delhi state chapter, and they organized the conference. Coimbatore, Dr. Asha Rao, wonderful bubbling energy at her age, and Damodar, lovely endoscopic surgeon, her son, they did a fantastic job. And believe me, all we team flew down. The convener may be anyone, but entire team with more faculty, we were there to support them, to cheer them. And Guwahati, I remember from Vancouver, directly flying to Guwahati from Delhi. It was a huge weekend, amazing place. And he connected all northeast area of India. And Arun, thank you so much. I met great endoscopic surgeons from Shillong and smaller cities over there. The workshop went on till night. Jaipur, another fantastic conference. Pragnesh has taken so much efforts along with his convener Kavita Bapat, and Leela Vyas has done a fabulous job with her team over there. We did one conference with Foxy. Dr. Nandita Palshetkar, our past president, she was my president when I was secretary. Our bond is very unique bond. Just by saying hello, we know what we are having in our minds. And we decided one conference we'll do together. And Ashwath, her vice president, the great endoscopic surgeon of the country. And then obviously his theme was endoscopy, and we enjoyed 3 days hospitality with him. Thank you, Ashwath, for making these efforts. The greatest leaders are not necessarily the ones who do great things. They are the ones that get people to do great things. That's important to learn. And then the UA conference again started in Nandita's presidency with me as a secretary. We had been to Latur, to Kanlan, and every year the presidents have promised us they will keep this activity going on. And this UA conference, none other than Dr. Sejal with her team, I wanted to work for. And believe me, thank you, Dr. Ashwath, for guiding this young force. They were working for entire year. They have done amazing job. 80% of the operative faculty were the youngsters. And she collected all youngsters. Their meetings were bubbling. Their evening programs were full of dances. We all know Gujarat. They don't stop without their functions, garbas and all. And we had a gala time in the evenings. They made us realize, or they on themselves also realize, that a dream does not become reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. Because they were young gynecologists, all came together. They were working nearly for a year. Now, we decided another program was to make the guidelines. We all understand that Foxy makes a fantastic guidelines. But there are certain areas in our field where there is always a dilemma, and that is fibroids and endometriosis. The pure endoscopic surgeon think differently. ART person think differently. They feel endoscopic surgeons are unnecessarily doing surgery, and ART endoscopist think differently. So we decided to make our own guidelines. So these two expert focus meetings were organized, and the standard guidelines were decided. And for this, I selected two most intelligent people. They were so sincere. They were so hardworking. They found out the best of the people from the country, and they made the fantastic index under which subheadings we should make a guideline. They allotted them to the groups. The groups have internally 2 months extensive discussion. Then they came together. One day they sat. So in September, we all sat in Mumbai and we did our meetings, presentations, and we came out our guidelines, which we released in Jaipur. Thank you, Manjula, for doing this wonderful job. You are so sincere, so humble, and so, so skillful surgeon. And endometriosis, Atul, your hotel which you chose was fantastic. After the extensive 2 months discussion, when we all went to that beautiful hotel near airport, we just enjoyed even the lunch over there, and no one wanted to go back and do the discussion. We were supposed to release it in Kolkata, but we should be releasing it soon or maybe today. Knowledge is knowing tomato is a fruit. Wisdom is not putting it into the fruit salad. And that is where we have many endoscopists. Probably they just learn in the conferences and they started doing the surgeries. So we wanted to enhance their skills also. We wanted to put up standard guidelines. So instead of a theory guideline, we decided to come up with the STAR dives, simplified endoscopic teachings with audio video recordings. So what we did is for this, we got into the team of, again, my managing committee members, and I allotted them the topics, and then they selected the surgeons. So they thought that the one who is in hysterectomy, the same surgeon will not be repeated in any other zone. So it needed a tremendous, huge coordination. And then calling them, asking them to do the video recording of a fantastic surgery, and then send us to, and then we kept on releasing. Our first release happened in Ahmedabad. So friends, we were working nearly 6 months before our installation. Nitin and Somel, you did amazing job. And these are all, most importantly, all these star drives are available on the website. Those who don't have it, those who were not there in the conference, naturally, they will be having it on the website. Abhishek and Kalyan, they have done on pelvic organ prolapse, and Damodar and Sejal had done it on hysteroscopy. Our remaining three were supposed to be in Kanpur, and one was in Bangalore, and one was in Kolkata, but probably we'll put them on a website for all of you to go through it. It was a huge job to get a quality audio video recording. And then the same hysterectomy with different pathologies, we compiled them together. And then we made that beautiful index and then gave it. Friends, it was a huge task. Again, a good teamwork, good networking. And thank you to each and every endoscopic surgeon who have taken out their time in editing, in audio recording, because there has to be a limit. So they have to run with 20 minutes. A river cuts through the rock, but not because of its power, but because of its persistence. And that is what has been taught this entire year. You need to be persistent. But suddenly, in a March, we all were attacked by corona. And all of a sudden, we received the message that we are under lockdown. Our Kanpur conference, we paid even to the hotel. Everything is standstill. I'm sure thanks to Dr. Kumar, who promised to continue this in their city. The first thing what happened was we made the guidelines, because everyone, obstetrics emergencies we were doing, elective surgeries were asked to stop. But in endoscopy also, we do have certain emergencies, twisted adnexa, ectopic. It's so cruel to open for an ectopic. And then we came out with our own good clinical practice recommendations during this COVID pandemic. And I thank to every person who has contributed. The best of the endoscopists, the senior having more than 10 years, 20 years experience, they come together, they came together, and we had nearly 5 meetings before we released them this in the month of May. It was very, very important. We thought every monthly, we'll keep on changing them. But more or less, the guidelines were so standard that we did not have to revise them. We met again, and in June, we thought whether we want to change anything, and nothing was changed. And these guidelines, I'm happy that most of the endoscopists of the country, they followed. Now, what I realize it, the entire 3 decades of your career, you never took a break. And suddenly Mr. Modi says us, sit at home. First 8 days went into rejection. We were not ready to accept this idea that do nothing and sit. Keep the beds for emergency patients. And then by 3rd week, 4th week, we started enjoying. And when we realized that we need to go for a work, this was my expression. I don't want to go back to work. I was started enjoying, spending time on myself, my exercises, my diet, my so many unfulfilled activities. And then the thought came, why not to start global virtual endoscopy summits? Friends, again, we made the history. For the first time in the global history of endoscopy, 12 hours from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., a big international conference we decided. I need to thank Zydus Sudeep and Onference Makran Dominic and his team because of them, we could do absolutely amazing conference. That conference was attended by 5,473 delegates across the globe from 97 countries. We had continuous, and at the end of a day, we were shocked. We did not realize how the time flew. And then the many calls started coming. Facebook pages loaded with, we enjoyed, we learned a lot. Imagine 23 international faculty with 40 national faculty teaching from morning 8 o'clock till 8 o'clock. It was a feast of endoscopy. No one moved out from their table. And then we thought, that's it. But so many messages, and we need to respect that. And they requested that please start on a theme with international and national faculty. And then we never believed, every Sunday from 2 o'clock till 6 o'clock on a theme topic, we came out. And 2,000, 3,000 delegates from more than 50, 60 countries. We did it in myoma. We did it beautifully on vaginal surgeries. I thank the great vaginal surgeons of our country and across who showed a huge uterus how to help us and how to improve our technical skills in it. And then we had also advanced laparoscopic surgery, neuropelvic anatomy. We never thought this will be such a fantastic topic. And everyone started coming, and we did not do one, two, three. We kept on doing, and we did 8 conferences all together. This fertility enhancing endoscopic surgeon, this conference had all our past presidents and all endoscopists with them coming together. Now, this V-Star, which we organized in first week of October, was my conference, which I wanted to give back to all the endoscopic surgeons who gave their time unconditionally entire year. And this V-Star conference with convener as Sejal and Ashish, we did it again from morning to evening. And then I realized that I cannot fit all of them, even if I do 15 minutes in entire day. There were so many who worked with me, and this was my departing conference. I wanted to show my respect for them. And then what we did with V-Star is, we did it in 2 parallel halls. Beautiful it was. You can come in one hall, this digital platform, and Makrand, your team, small things, certificates, selfie point, everything was there in this. And we had 2 parallel halls running simultaneously. So this was one of the best and the last conference we had. And every virtual endoscopy conference online, people got the certificate. I really made lots and lots of international friends, endoscopists. They are not in 10 and 20s, they are in hundreds. I was flooded with the friend request, and I'm not so friendly with the Facebook. And I used to sit just 2 hours to just give a respect to them. I don't wanted to give a image of, oh, we don't care. So I have now a lot of endoscopists across as the friends. Friends, whether we did only academics? No. We did many parallel activities. I always told everyone, instead of wondering when your next vacation is, maybe you should set up a life you don't need to escape. So what are the various activities we did? Again, the book. Release of this international book on hysteroscopy. Hysteroscopy is simplified by me and Bhaskar Pal. I need to thank Sujata Kar and Sejal for helping us and making us beautiful, beautiful index and getting the best of the hysteroscopic surgeon across the globe to contribute in those. We will be releasing this book after my installation, and I want to thank and I requested all my authors to join. So Makrant, make sure that you are making them join. Release of an annual book. Bhaskar must have said, are you going crazy? Because our book is of 140 pages. What I thought is, it is a digital book. I'm not going to print. So number of prints, number of pages, the cost, printing, the weight, postage, all that doesn't come. I'm just going to put it on this. So why not to give a beautiful, colorful with all the photos, and our 140 pages ebook will be released today. It was a massive task of remembering and collecting. Thanks to Suzette, my secretary, Sejal, Abhishek, and all zonal coordinators, of whether they are Star or Eagle or Bali, they kept on collecting and giving me from time to time. Membership drive is the aim of our organization every year. We believe that our strength lies in the membership. Naturally, we decided, let's make at least 500 new members. And I'm happy to announce my whole team work, and we got 514 new members for the year. If my team always says, Corona nahi hota, to aur member hote. But it's okay. It's an ongoing process, and I'm sure many more got stimulated and they will become a member. Next most important thing is felicitation of a past president. Again, we took advantage of this corona situation. If we can do digitally, why not to have all past presidents who have done amazing work in their tenure, unbelievable, and they got this IOG to this platform. Why not to get them all digitally together and do a felicitation of all our past president with Pride of IIG Award. And in week star conference, believe me, we had tears in our eyes when Dr. Nargis Motasha, Dr. Swati Dave, I need to thank you. I think 40 years, 50 years, 60 years, I don't know how many years of association with Dr. Nargis Motasha. No daughter would have done how much you have done. You went all the way so that she can sit and be with us. Dr. Adi Dastur, Dr. Shyam Desai, Dr. Prashant Mangeshikar, Dr. Rishikesh Pai, Dr. my most favorite, that's why. It happens because he is leading so many organizations, Prakash Trivedi, Rajendra Sangpal, Nandita Pal Shetkar, and Reshma Pai. We all thank you from bottom of heart for guiding us again and again and help taking our organization to the international level that we could think of collaborating with AGL, and AGL thought of IAG worth a collaboration. And that's where we wanted to recognize you. We thank you for your time and coming with those mementos. I thank Atul for making those mementos and Sudeep ensuring that all those people receive. State chapter installation. Dr. Reshma Pai started this state chapters. We had Tamil Nadu installation and Northeast installation in our tenure. There were four which were lined up from March to May because it's not so easy. You have to get the state together. You have to get the all endoscopies. You have to work out the seniority and you have to make the team with those seniority. So we did another four lined up. But they want to do it when probably the physical conference and installation. So maybe in coming years, we'll have all state chapters coming in. I thank both of them, Mala with Kurian Joseph as a chairperson and Arun Baruda for doing this all conferences. Friends, coming to the end, I cannot just stop it without thanking my team. My team is my pride. You can see, when it was a virtual Zoom meetings, when we were discussing about endoscopy program, we had huge attendance. But when we had physical meetings, that time also, the entire team used to be there. You will never see this column going down and down. Again, I must say, Prakash, Pikesha always attended all the conference, all our managing committee meetings, just to ensure, just to support, just to give us any different way we can think of, or whether we are going in a right way. But believe me, they always encouraged. I must have received a phone call from Prakash many times saying that you are doing good work, please keep on doing. Thank you, Prakash, for that each and every phone call and for each and every messages what you gave me. That really boosted our energy. I know this is a very big dialogue I'm putting into for my team. Teamwork is the ability to work together towards a common vision. And they believed in my vision. They worked selflessly. And that's what was important. I still remember Dr. B. Ramesh saying to me, I think I felt today that IIG belongs to me and I belong to IIG. B. Ramesh, those words are still lingering in my mind. Thank you for those beautiful words. The ability to direct individual accomplishments toward organizational objectives. You can do your own teaching institute, but you are making it through or under the aegis of IIG, making organization bigger than the self. It is the fuel that allows the common people like me to attain uncommon results. And that's where my team come to. Friends, I thank you all, but I cannot end without thanking my family. They are my roots and they are my wings. The entire, it's not only Dr. Rajesh and Rishi. Dr. Rajesh traveled with me for every star conferences, but my entire family allowed me to skip many family functions. Except birthdays, I have not attended any family functions because every weekend was busy. It is my circle of strength. And thank you, Rishi, for this beautiful drone photograph. I cannot enough thank Silas, my CEO, and Suzette, my beautiful secretary, who is stuck in Dubai. She left on 18th March for 2 days, and she's stuck there. But I love you, Suzette, and be safe, stay safe. Friends, nothing in the life is possible without a guru. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Sri Guruve Namaha. I think it's so important that everyone has a guru. When you are focused on being blessed, God makes it sure that you are always blessed in abundance, and what you think will happen. You just need to think. So if you carry God with you, He's always there helping you, guiding you, protecting you. That's very important. Friends, with folded hands and with complete humble mind, I say thank you to all of you for being with me and for listening to me for last half hour patiently. Thank you so much. And I wish a beautiful, beautiful organization, IIG, to grow to further heights, and every president, Dr. Krishna Kumar with his team who is getting installed. I'm sure Krishna Kumar has amazing creative idea, and most important is he's very hardworking, very sincere. You tell her, Krishna Kumar, can you draft this letter for me? And within half hour, the letter will be in on your mail. I have no doubt that this organization will go to the another level with Bhaskar, Pandit, Atul, and Kalyan. The organization will keep on growing, and I will be more than happy to be there with you all as a past president. Thank you and love you all.